हेलो, गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स. सी, वेलकम बैक टू अवर ई लर्निंग सेशन एंड इट इज इनिशिएटेड बाय विद्याधीश विद्या संकुल अंडर द गाइडेंस ऑफ डॉक्टर जी एम सुतरिया सर. ओके, एंड सी, इन अवर लास्ट लेक्चर वी कंप्लीट अप टू इलस्ट्रेशन नंबर 26 एंड वी कंप्लीट अवर मेथड नंबर 8. ओके, नाउ we'll discuss our next method, that is on page number 187, marginal income and marginal cost. Okay, see, I hope you all complete your 4 mark sum, that is illustration number 25 and illustration number 26, as well as I was give you a homework of section E of maximum and minimum value of a function. And you have any doubts, then ask me, WhatsApp me, and I will solve it in my large difficulty lectures. Okay, now, or we will discuss it with in our face-to-face class also. See here, now the next topic is marginal income and marginal cost. I am reading that particular topic, but first of all, we will start with this. Okay, what is that? First of all, see that the differentiation is used to obtain the solution of our economic and business problems. We have seen that the first and second order derivative can be used to obtain the maximum and minimum value of our function. See, we already use all these things, first derivative, second derivative, and also we will use it to find out the maximum and minimum value of the function. Okay, now first order derivative of a function can also be used to obtain the marginal income and the marginal cost. See, you already study about the marginal income and marginal cost in 11th standard in the economics subject. We have to discuss that practically here by doing the differentiation of first derivative of the function. Okay, so you can find out the marginal cost as well as marginal income of a function by using of differentiation, that means only first derivative, first differentiation. In study of economics, the relation between the price and the demand of a commodity can be represented as a function, right? Price and demand, as well as supply and demand, as well as supply and price, all are considered, all are studied in the function form, right? If we denote the price of a function commodity by P, what is the price? That is small p, right? And the demand by X, that is X is your demand and P is your price, right? We get the relation X is equal to F of P. What is X? X means demand. Demand is equal to function of price. What is that? X is equal to demand of, what is this? P is equal to here price, and X is equal to demand. So demand is equal to function of price, right? That is X is equal to F of P, which is called the demand function. It is called, see here, X is equal to demand, and that's why it is called a demand function. Okay, if the income or revenue obtained by the selling X units of a commodity is denoted by R. See, R means capital R is equal to revenue. So here the function of revenue What means of revenue? What is the income? See, multiplication of demand into price, that is called a revenue. What is the function of revenue? Is equal to, revenue is equal to demand into price. So we are denoted demand as X, price is equal to P. That's why we can say here, therefore R is equal to X into P, small p. Revenue, that is income of a business, that is called a revenue, and revenue is denoted by, what is the formula for revenue? See, this one is the formula for revenue. Revenue is equal to, see, you have to write this formula, you have to write all these things in your example book. This is your formula. See, here I am explaining you, here we are denoting demand as X, then price as P, and here it is a demand function. X is equal to F of P is a demand function. Here into the question, demand function is given, always always demand function is given. Or see, if only X and P is given, that is demand and the price of a function of a commodity is given, then we have to find out the revenue by this formula. Revenue is equal to, or income is equal to, demand into price, that is X into P. This is the formula for revenue. And thus the revenue R is a function of demand. See here, revenue, that is R, is a function of demand X, right? So here we have to see that, we have to find out the first revenue function. The revenue function is equal to X into P, right? Next one, the change in the revenue due to small change in the demand, it is called marginal revenue. See, you already know about that. What is the marginal revenue? See, what is the total revenue up to the sale of 10 units, and what is the total revenue of selling 11th unit? So difference between these two, that is the sale price of the 11th commodity, that is called a marginal revenue, right? What is the marginal revenue? See the definition, the change in revenue due to small changes in demand is called a marginal revenue. This is the definition of marginal revenue here. See, in the economics, the definition of marginal revenue is different. Here the marginal revenue, in the statistics, in the differentiation chapter, the formula for the definition for marginal revenue is different. See here, we have to consider the definition of marginal revenue in the statistics, only this formula, right? Only this definition. Marginal revenue can be obtained by taking the derivative of revenue function with respect to X. See, here we have to find out. See, this one is the revenue function, right? But we want marginal revenue. And what is the formula for marginal revenue? See, the marginal revenue can be obtained by taking the derivative, that is first order derivative, first differentiation of revenue function with respect to X. With respect to X. So what is the marginal revenue? See here, marginal revenue is equal to d by dx of R. Revenue function, differentiation of revenue function with respect of X. Differentiation, that is first order derivative, first differentiation of revenue function with respect to X, that is called a marginal revenue. Okay, so the formula for marginal revenue is here. Marginal revenue is equal to dr by dx. You can say, you can write here like that. Marginal revenue is equal to dr by dx. You can write like this also and like this also, dr, but R is always capital. See, you have to write R as a capital because R denotes a revenue function, that is capital R, revenue. Capital R means revenue, and revenue function only denotes by capital R. That's why if you want to find out the marginal revenue, you have to write compulsory DR, but D and DX all are in small letters, but R must be in the capital letter. That's why DR by DX is the formula for marginal revenue. Okay, see the formula here. Marginal revenue is equal to DR by DX, but R is always capital here. Now, if we denote the cost of producing X units by C, that is capital C, always here cost function. See here, C is a cost function, R is a revenue function. R is always capital, as well as here, whenever we are finding out the cost function or whenever we are finding out the marginal cost, here again C is always capital. Marginal, if we denote the cost of producing X units by C, then C can be can also be represented as a function of X. C, that is cost function. Okay, so first of all, see, this is your method number. See here, first method, that is differentiation by definition. Second method, simple differentiation. Third, fourth and fifth, division rule, multiplication rule, division rule and chain rule. Then sixth method is second derivative. Then seventh method is increasing or decreasing the function. Eighth method is maximum and minimum value of a function. And here is now the marginal cost and marginal revenue is your method number 9. So first of all, write down that method number 9. Marginal cost and marginal revenue is your method number 9. So first of all, write down this, then I will explain you the cost function as well as the marginal cost. Okay, so first of all, write down this. Okay, so complete marginal revenue. Now we'll start with marginal cost. See, revenue function is denoted by X into P, but X function, C, cost function is not denoted by any of the number. C is equal to only capital C is equal to cost function only. And if we want marginal cost, that is first derivative, marginal cost, that is first derivative of a cost function. See here, d upon dx of c, or you can write dc by dx, that is marginal cost, right? This is the formula. See, cost function, whenever you have to find out the marginal revenue, only demand and price is given. You have to prepare first revenue function and then find out the marginal cost. But whenever you have to find out, marginal revenue, and whenever you have to find out the marginal cost, cost function is directly given into the question, and then you have to just find out the marginal cost. See the difference between marginal revenue and marginal cost. In the marginal revenue, if we want to find out, if they ask to find out the marginal revenue, then they only give a X and P, that is demand and price, separately they give on. We have to multiply that and find out the revenue function first and then find out the marginal revenue. But whenever we have to find out the marginal cost, directly cost function is given, that is C is directly given into the question, and we just have to find out the first derivative of that particular function, that is your marginal cost. Okay, so here marginal revenue and marginal cost, both the formula for both the cost and revenue are given here. First of all, write down this. See here, I am reading that. I am repeating that. If we denote the cost of producing X units by C, then C can also be a represent as function of X, that is here, right? And the change is cost in cost due to small change in the production is called a marginal cost, right? Here marginal cost can be obtained by taking the derivative of a cost function with respect to X. Derivative of cost function with respect to X, that is called a marginal cost. Okay, thus when we production, when the production is X, then marginal cost is equal to dc by dx, but C is always capital. In the marginal revenue, R is capital. In the cost, marginal cost, C is always capital. So dr by dx and dc by dx, in both cases R and C are capital, other letters must be small. Okay, see, complete this. Now we'll move forward to our next illustration, that is illustration number 27, and I am reading that particular illustration. Illustration number 27, if the demand function of pizza, right, in lockdown we all remember more than two times, three times that when we eat the pizzas. Here the questions regarding pizza, demand of pizza, price of pizza is given, and we have to find out the marginal the demand is 3, we have to find out the marginal revenue of pizza parlor. Okay, so here see the question. If the demand function of a pizza is price, is P is equal to 150 minus 4x. See, the demand function is given, that is P is equal to 150 minus 4x is given, right? Then the find the marginal revenue. See here, P is given, we have to multiply, we have to find out the revenue. First of all, we have to find out the revenue from that. What is the formula for revenue? X into P. P is already given, we have to just multiply X to the particular P, and we find out the revenue first, and from that particular revenue we can find out the marginal revenue by taking that function first derivative or first differentiation. When the demand is 3 pizza, we have to find out the marginal revenue, then we have to put X is equal to 3. When the demand is of 3 pizza, and interpret it, what is the demand of 3 pizza, what is the marginal revenue of third pizza, and we have to interpret it. Okay, so here I am writing that. See, method number 9, marginal cost and marginal revenue. Illustration number 27. See, X is equal to, here P is equal to 150 minus 4X is given. We have to find out marginal revenue. When X is equal to 3,
right? So we have to find out these, but first of all we have just P only, right? And if we have only P, then we have to find out first revenue, then marginal revenue. See, this is the step I told you. Whenever I am explaining you here marginal revenue and marginal cost, here whenever in the question of finding out the marginal revenue, they only gives us a price function or a demand function. Here they give us a demand function. See the question, if the demand function of a pizza, that is here, this one is the demand function, and from that particular demand function we have to first of all find out the revenue function. See, what is the revenue function? Revenue is equal to R is equal to X into P, right? So what is your R here? Therefore R is equal to X into, what is P? 150 minus 4X. See, I am putting the value of P here. Now multiply of these into these and multiply of these into this, open the bracket. So here what is the revenue function? 150x minus 4x square, right? Okay, so this one is your first step. That is, here whenever they give us only the demand function or whenever they give us only a price function, we have to first of all find out the revenue function by multiplying X into P. So whenever P is given, we have to multiply X. Whenever X is given, we have to multiply P. So here X into P, that is your revenue function, and your revenue function is now here. This one is your first answer, that is your revenue function. Okay. Now we have to find out the marginal revenue first. So what is the marginal revenue here? DR by DX that is differentiation of this function 150x minus 4x square. And what is the differentiation of this? 150 into x, what is the differentiation of x? 150 into 1, that is your answer is 150 minus 4x square. So what is the differentiation of x square? That is 2x. Here x raised to n is equal to, what is the differentiation of x raised to n? N into x raised to n minus 1. So 2 into x raised to 2 minus 1 again. Okay, so we have to write only 1 here, we don't have to write on the power 1. That is 2x is the differentiation of x square into 4, that is here 8x is your answer of differentiation 4x square. What is the differentiation of 4x square? 4 to the 8x, x raised to 2 minus 1, that is 1. So 8x is your first differentiation. So your marginal revenue is 150 minus 8x. Now we have to put the value of 3 because we want marginal revenue at when x is equal to 3, right? So here we have to put the value 3. Here I am writing that, please. When the demand of pizza is equal to 3, therefore x is equal to 3, marginal revenue is equal to 150 minus 8 into 3. We have to put just 3 as x, right? So here, what is that? What is the marginal revenue? 150 minus 8, 3s are 24. So your marginal revenue is equal to 126.
Marginal revenue of third pizza. See, marginal revenue of third pizza is rupees 126. So your interpret it. See the question. Find out the marginal revenue when x is equal to 3. We are finding out that the marginal revenue when x is equal to 3 is 126. But we have to write, because the question that interpret it. So we have to write that. Thus, interpretation. We have to write the interpretation here. See, write down the interpretation. Revenue for selling the fourth pizza.
See, when x is equal to 3, we have to write fourth pizza. See, up to 3, the answer is 126. So the marginal revenue of selling the fourth pizza, that is the next one, selling of fourth pizza is approximately 126. This is the interpretation. We have to write particular one mark answer, that is revenue for selling of the fourth pizza. Interpretation, interpret it. There specifically question is that interpret it. We have to just find out first the price function is given here. We have to find out the revenue from that. That is the revenue function is here. Now, from revenue function, we want marginal revenue. So marginal revenue, that is first differentiation of this revenue function. That is the, here is the answer of marginal revenue. And we want marginal revenue when x is equal to 3. So here, when x is equal to 3, the marginal revenue is 126 rupees. So we have to interpret it. That's why the interpretation is equal to revenue for selling fourth pizza. See, this one is the x. So here we have to write the next one compulsory, right? So revenue for selling of fourth pizza is approximately rupees 126 is your perfect answer. And see here, this is your only 2 marks sum, but if you don't write this, then 1.5 marks will cut here. Here up to this, your first 1.5 mark is here, but the interpretation is must. That's why you have to write this line compulsory as your part of the answer. Okay, so write down this, your interpretation as well as your full sum, full example in your example book. Example number 27 is over here. Now the next example, first of all write down this. Okay, see, it is very easy. Marginal revenue and marginal cost, both topic are very easy, so don't worry about that. Now see the next illustration on page number 188, that is illustration number 28. If the demand function of a commodity is x is equal to 50 minus p upon 2. See here into the question, the demand function, see the demand function. Demand function is given in P. The main point is P is equal to 150 minus 4x. But whenever the demand function is given into the x, we have to convert first into the format of P. Then and then we can find out the revenue function. and then we can find out the marginal revenue. So here, whenever into the question, the demand function is given in the X form, X is equal to, then we have to convert that into the P form. Always, whenever the demand function is given into the P form, that is P is equal to 150 minus 4X, then we can find out the simple, that is revenue first, then marginal revenue, and then put the value of X in the marginal revenue and find out the next next commodity marginal revenue or price. Okay, but here the function is given into the X form, right? See the question, X is equal to 50 minus P upon 2. First of all, we have to convert that into the P form, and then we can find out the revenue function. This is the steps. Okay, so here keep in mind always, or you have to write in your fair book compulsory, whenever the question is given into the P form, that is demand function is given into the P form, then it is okay. Then we just have to find out the revenue, then marginal revenue, and then put the value of X into the marginal revenue. But whenever the question is given, that is demand function is given into the X form, first of all we have to convert that into the P form, and then we put the value here, where then we step, where then we continue with these particular steps. Okay. So write down in your fair book, and I am writing here illustration number 28. So here demand function is given in the X form, so we have to convert that into the P form. See here, X is equal to 50 minus P upon 2. So here first of all we have to multiply. See, we have to convert that here, all these things on the opposite side of the is equal to. So here 2, we have to first of all divide 2. Is divided, see the function into the function, 2 is divided, that is 2 is in the denominator, and if we want to transfer that on the opposite side, then we have to multiply it with the X. That's why what is the next step here, 2X is equal to 50 minus P, right? This one is the steps. 2x, 2 is divide here, so whenever I want to transfer it on the opposite side of the is equal to, then we have to multiply it with X. That's why 2x is equal to 50 minus P as it is. Now we want P as a main, so here we want to transfer that P on the opposite side and 2x on the opposite side. So here we can write that P is equal to 50 minus 2x. P given, P transfer on the opposite side of is equal to, that is minus P becomes a positive P, that is plus P, and 2x is positive here, it is transfer on the opposite side of is equal to, then it will become a minus 2x. Positive become negative and negative become positive by transferring the both on the opposite side of is equal to. That's why now this is the demand function of P, that is price. Demand function of price is here. Now we can find out the revenue function from this. What is the formula for revenue function? X into P. What is your X? X into 50 minus 2x. So 50x minus 2x square. That is your revenue function. See here, into the question, x is given as a demand function. We are converting that x into p form. That is, now p is equal to 50 minus 2x. This is your main question. Now we have to just put the revenue function formula. Revenue is equal to x into p, x into the formula of p, that is the function of p, that is 50 minus 2x. Now multiplication, x into 50, that is 50x, minus 2x into x, that is 2x square. This one is your revenue function. Okay, now see here, we have to find out the marginal revenue. What is that? D R by DX. R must be capital. So here, differentiation of this D by DX of 50x minus 2x square. What is the differentiation? See here, 50x, that is 50 minus 2 to the 4x. This is your marginal revenue. Okay. So here the marginal revenue is equal to 50 minus 4x. Okay. Now what we want? Marginal revenue when price is 10. Sorry, not 10, it is 30. Marginal revenue when the price is 30, rupees 30. Okay. So when price is 30, what is the x? First of all, we have to find out also x. P is equal to 30. First we have to find out what is x, right? So formula for x is equal to 50 minus p upon 2, right? So here 50 minus 30 divided by 2, that is 20 divided by 2, that is 10. Here price, not x. P is equal to 30 is given here. See, twist into the question. In first question, x is given, and we just have to find out the marginal revenue by putting x is equal to 3. But here, into this question, the function, demand function, is given in the x form. We have to convert that into the p form first. Then we find out the revenue, and then we find out the marginal revenue. And then, what is the question? See, again the style of the question is changed. Marginal revenue when price is 30. But what is the demand? What is your x? Here it is not given. We have to find out that also. When price is 30, first of all find out x. X is equal to what? X is equal to 50 minus p upon 2, whatever is given. We have to just put 30 as p here into the equation, into the function. And here we get the x is equal to 10. But now we want the marginal revenue when x is equal to 10. So here I am writing here, when x is equal to 10, that is demand is equal to 10, what is the marginal revenue? Is equal to, this is the function, marginal revenue function, 50 minus 4 into 10, 50 minus 40, the answer is rupees 10. Answer is rupees 10. Marginal revenue is 10. And what is the interpretation? See here, the interpretation of this question will not ask, but we have to write the answer. That is, interpretation What is the interpretation? See here.
Write down that particular revenue for selling. See, what is your X? X is equal to 10. Revenue for selling the 11th. Next of these, next of X. Here, not 31. Here, X is equal to 10. So you have to write 11. Selling 11th. 11th unit is rupees 10. Revenue for selling 11th. Unit is rupees approximately rupees 10. This is your final answer, that is interpretation. Okay, so here your illustration number 28 is also over. That is, demand function is given in the X form. That is the new style of the question. And we have to convert that into the P form. Then find out the revenue function. Then find out the marginal revenue. And then find out when price is given. We have to find out first X. X is equal to 10 here. Then we put the value of X in the marginal revenue function. And find out which is the price of marginal revenue, then at the selling of the for the selling of 11th unit. Okay, so here this is your interpretation and this is your answer of illustration 28. Please write down this and we will move forward to our next illustration. So first of all, write down this marginal revenue. Only two illustration for marginal revenue, that is different types of question of marginal revenue is given here, example 27 as well as example 28. Now the next example is for the marginal cost function. Write down this. First of all, it is very easy, right? Only one twist is here into the question, nothing else. So here whenever we are converting this, we have to converting here also. When price is given, we have to find out the X also. X directly not given into this question, so we have to find out also X here. Okay, now move forward to our next illustration, that is illustration number 29. I am reading that particular illustration. The cost function of a commodity. See, I told you, whenever into the revenue function X, that is demand function, X or P is given, and we have to find out first of all the revenue function and then find out the marginal revenue and then put the value of X into the marginal revenue. But here into the cost function, into the marginal cost, whenever we have to find out the marginal cost, directly cost function is given. We don't have to find out the cost function into the question. Cost function is directly given. So it is very simple as well as very easy, right? See here, the cost function of a commodity is C is equal to 5x square plus 6x plus 2000. Here the cost function is given. X is the number of units produced and we have to find out the marginal cost when the production is 50 units. Okay, so here I am doing that. Illustration number 29. See, the cost function is given. C, capital C always. Capital C is equal to 5x square plus 6x plus 2000. It is given. That is, cost function is given. And we have to find out the marginal cost.
when production, that is x is equal to 50 units. We have to find out this marginal cost when x is equal to 50 units. We have to find out that. Okay, so here the cost function is given. C is equal to 5x square plus 6x plus 2000. We want marginal cost directly from this. We don't have to find out the cost function because it is already given into the question. So your marginal cost is equal to dc by dx. So d by 5x square plus 6x plus 2000 by dx. So the answer is 5 2s 10x, 6 1s 6 and 2000 0. What is the differentiation of 5x square, 5 2s 10x? What is the differentiation of 6x? X differentiation is 1, 6 into 1, that is 6, plus 2000 is the constant. That's why the differentiation of 2000 is 0. So your marginal cost is 10x plus 6. Okay, this is your marginal cost. And we want when x is equal to 50 units, that is production of 50 units, what is the marginal revenue, marginal cost? Ten into 50 plus 6, that is 500 plus 6, that is 506 rupees. What is the interpretation? See here, interpretation of this is we have to here see in the revenue function, in the marginal revenue, we are selling the production, the product or commodity, and we are getting the money, that is called revenue. That's why here at that time in the interpretation we have to write that for selling of next unit, what is the revenue, that is the approximately, this is the marginal revenue of that particular 11th or 10th or next unit sale. Okay, here the cost of the function. So to produce the next unit, see here, what is the next unit? Here x is given 50. So to production, to produce 51st unit, approximately cost of produce 51 units is here rupees 506. So interpretation is the cost of the production of 51 unit is approximately rupees 506. The cost of producing, the cost of production, not production, producing, the cost of producing the 51st unit is approximately 506 rupees. Okay, so here your very easy illustration of 2 marks, illustration number 27, 28 and 29 is over. First of all, this one is also very easy, only 2 to 3 steps are there. So please write down this, and now the time for homework. Please write down this. section C, question number 11,
that is marginal revenue. Then section C again,
question number 20 is also marginal cost. This one is for marginal revenue, this one is for marginal cost. Now section D, question number 15, marginal revenue. Then question number 19,
question number 20.
So here five questions, section C and section D fully solved. Here fully complete section C and D. Here marginal cost and marginal revenue, all the questions of marginal revenue, marginal cost, as well as increasing or decreasing the function, as well as the maximum and minimum function value of the function. We complete all the topics up to method number 9, and also we complete section C and D here. In your exercise book you have to write this, and I told you that you have to write again and again. You have to practice these questions into your rough book 2-3 times, as well as you have to write these all the examples in your example book, and you have to write all these questions, that is exercise, in your exam exercise book. Okay, here I'm complete my lecture. So have a good day. Thank you, class.